And now for today's Bible question. Today we have learned about how Jesus had power to give people freedom from Satan, disease, and from death itself. We learned about a 12-year-old girl that had died and was brought back to life by Jesus. Someone might ask the question, why does God sometimes allow children to die? It is a very sad truth that sometimes children die. This brings such heartbreak to the parents who have loved and looked after their child from the time they were born. If children are a gift from God, then why would God take them back when they have so much life before them? I recall seeing a woman running into the hospital with her young, lifeless daughter hanging over her shoulders and screaming and shouting for someone to help her. The pain of losing a child can hardly be compared with any other human tragedy. So why would God allow us to experience such a devastating loss? When older people die, we accept it because we know they have had a chance to live a long and full life. But we think it is so unfair that a child, with their whole life in front of them, should tragically be taken away in death. Of course, our difficulty in understanding the death of children is due to our limited view of things. If we could see things from God's perspective, then we would not only see tragedy in the death of a child, but we would also see hope as well. Just as Jairus had to suffer great fear and heartache because of his daughter's death, he also had great joy of seeing her raised up to life again. For Christians and young children, death is not the end of their life, but just the beginning. Death is a doorway through which we enter a far better place, where we shall forever be in the presence of Jesus, who gives and sustains all life. For a parent to lose a child and know they are now with Jesus brings great comfort. Of course, we miss those who have died, but we can be assured that if they are God's children, then He has taken them to their eternal and joyful home in heaven. Someday, Christian parents who have lost children will be reunited with them in heaven, and it will be even more joyful than when Jesus brought back Jairus' daughter. I recall a boy of 7 years being tragically taken in a car accident, and someone who had a close relationship to the boy was very angry at God for taking the child away at such a tender age. I told that angry person that we should not expect that when God gives life to a person, He owes it to them to give them a good and long life. God does not owe us anything at all, and everything we have, whether great or small, is His precious gift, and we should thank Him for everything that we do receive. I said we should thank God for those 7 years that He gave, and not be angry for the years we think should have been added. God in His wisdom had better plans for that little boy that may have spared him much suffering in this world, allowing him the privilege of enjoying heaven sooner than others. Perhaps another reason why God allows children to be taken from us sometimes is because He is trying to speak to our hearts about our need for salvation. There is nothing more sobering than the reality of death, especially when we see it in a child who we expect to be healthy and to live on for many more years. When children die, it reminds us how frail we all are and how close to death we are. Any of us may not even see tomorrow. God may use the untimely death of a child or a tragic illness or some other drastic means to grab our attention and make us think about eternal things and our need to prepare ourselves for the day of our departure from this world. Have you received Christ as your personal Savior by faith? Perhaps today is the day you will give your heart to Him and find assurance of life beyond the grave. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 6.